Yo, what's up, YouTube? This is the one only kid with one piece of the new fear gaming. So today I'll be bringing you a draft champion gameplay. As you can see, I'm drafting this goatee squad. Tell you a little bit about fair gaming. Me and my boy Walking Hack, we starting a gaming channel. We just bringing the best content: Madden, 2K, Call of Duty, GTA, FIFA, everything. And I'm on this Madden video and in the next few Madden videos, I'm gonna be teaching you how to draft a really good team. Because that's what I do, you know, draft champions guru. So as you can see, I'm picking up my boy Big Dalvin Cook. You gotta have two running backs. Anytime you got two running backs, you know, it make the world easy. Then, you know, if you got two running backs, you might want to get a wide receiver like a block. Because if you get a little receiver with speed, yeah, they're nice, yeah, they're cool, they're fun, but you want to get one like a block. And for corners, either you only get one with really good speed or really good press if you like to press up. I like to press up. I like speed and press at the same time. And you can see I'm getting Delaney Walker because his run block is higher than the rest because I'm a runner. I like to run. So run block is a major factor. You know I got to get Michael Vick. I'm just playing around, trying to look at other people's stats. But you know I got to get Vick. Trying to get the best offensive lineman. I'm going to teach you how to really build an easy, winnable team. Not with all the flashes. I can get into that later. But to build a winning team, you need running backs. You need linemen. You need a few receivers with good route running and blocking. You need corners. And maybe two linebackers to make sure you can stop the run. And a DN. Two DNs. You don't really want to overdraft wide receivers. You don't need five. You barely need three or four, to be honest. You don't want to overdraft defensive linemen. You really only need two. Maybe three. But you don't need two D tackles or a sub out D linemen. For linebackers, you wanna look for play reg. You wanna look for play reg, you wanna look for pursuit, you wanna look for tackle. So when the computer is on him, he's not getting broke by good running backs, he's just doing his job. He got hit power, of course. You see how his hit power and his tackling is really high? I already got a middle linebacker, but I'm gonna take another one because he has the stats and I can move him around. For safety, you wanna get somebody with that boom and speed. Jamal Adam. He's the perfect combo. You can see I'm finna get DJ Metcalf. I see he's 6'3 with speed. Nah, I'm gonna get Calvin really. So I was thinking about getting DJ Metcalf, but he don't have route running. Cause you always wanna get route running. You wanna get anything. You know, Jadeveon Clowney is the best one here. But you wanna get something because if you don't have route running, all his intangibles don't matter unless you run the street. Because essentially, he'll get his route ran for him. And if you play Madden, you know what I mean when I say he get his route ran. Like, literally, the DB will run where he's supposed to be going. And you will throw it because you'll think the DB's not going to run there. He's already running there. Now, yeah, as you can see, I need a couple wide receivers because I only got two. So I'm going to take Andre Reed. Got to finish my draft off by taking Ronnie Lott. I was thinking about getting Ray Lewis, but I already got two in the linebacker, so I went and got Ronnie Lott. Switched my playbook to the Saints playbook because they got to go to playbook. You can see I drafted an 87 overall. That's a pretty good overall. 88, 87. I've drafted I want to say 89 before, but 87 is pretty good. As you can see, I'm trying to mix my lineup back up, trying to put my two running backs in at running back, not one at fullback, one at running back, because I don't have time for a fullback. I'd rather have a running back at running back so I can sub him in and out. Not me trying to run a lineup and my running back is blocking from my other running back. I don't think that's pretty productive. And as you can see, they got my offensive line all jumbled up. All that don't really matter to me. I don't know. Maybe somebody have a better tip or they understand it more, they can explain. But I feel like with run block and pass block, if it's a running pass block, no matter what position they're at, they're going to run and pass block. So, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, my defense pretty sticky. I had to move Bethea as my third corner because I don't have enough. Let's get into this gameplay though. My opponent got the ball first. You can see first and 10. He got Christian McCaffrey. He got Kyler Murray. He throw it right at me. Madden don't give it to me. So that happens a lot. But you know, second and 10. I'm back out and I'm ready. He's going to get a stop. He's going to toss it. I can't get there. He made me look bad. We come back out. It's not second and 6. We know we got to get a stop on this drive. We got to come out hard. I like to come out blazing. Make sure my defense put a statement up. I see him. I'm reading it all. And he finally went down. We back to second and 10. He entered into the red zone.
Again, second and 10.
I follow that route. He threw it the other way. I'm trying to strip him. That's my favorite thing. The R1 button is real strong. Alright, he in the red zone now. Second and 10. Now, second and 7. It's time to put that stick on him. Gotta make sure he ain't in the end zone. That's a sack. Third and 14 after the big sack. I'm out here trying to get to the quarterback. They got me stuck on the defensive line, but it don't matter because somebody's going to get to him. D4. All right, my first play of offense after my opponent takes 3 points. You know I want to come establish that run. Hit the hole. Give him the spin move, and I'm out of there. It's too easy. I'm gone.
Got him.
And as you can see, he dove the wrong way but caught me. But you can see X look wide open on his play, so I think I'm going to go in and hit X. I pressed the wrong button, throw the triangle, but Madden bails me out. It's just not going to make me throw a pick. He shut me down for the rest of that possession, so I'm going to tie the game up 3-3. I know if I can tie it up 3-3, I'm still in this ball game. He got ball first. And only I can stop him and stop me. I'm all good. So my opponent on second and 3. He running right up the middle, get stuck on the lineman and break out. You know I'm not like a run man, but I don't have enough points to run man, so I'm forced to run zone. I'm not really a zone fan, because zone don't really do good for me. Man, you can see he got a new set of down. I'm following the route. He don't got nowhere to throw it to now. Gonna take that easy coverage sack. Jadeveon Clowney. Jadeveon Clowney is probably top 3 best linemen on the game. As you can see, he cutting in. I'm following that route. He throw it. Madden bail him out. He throw the coverage off his back foot and Madden bail him out. So he punted the ball pretty good. I think they got my backup quarterback in the game. I was really confused a lot. And look what kind of shuffle pass he did. Alright, second and 14. I take make sure Vic back in the game because I don't know what we're going on. Okay, Skeena been in the game. As you can see, I'm going to roll out with Vic. I'm going to test that little speed he got, that little 88 speed. He hit the sideline. He got out of bounds. Good run, Vic. Third and 7. I know I need this first down bad. Because if I don't get this first down, I'm in pretty bad shape. I throw a dot. But he get hit when he dropped the ball. So yes, I am a punter, but I gotta go for runs 4th and 7 because I knew that one was supposed to be completed. If I roll out, throw it over the top, that's another dot. Find my boy Coleman for the easy little street route. I'm digging this Michael Vick car. He's like top 3 quarterback on Drive Champions for me. I'm making sure I'm letting him do his adjustments because people normally over adjust when you take your time to pre-snap. But I know him for running the ball up the gut.
They'll run with Coleman on first.
Hey, I bounced off a lineman like he did that one time. Got into the red zone. That's easy money. Second and 19. I'm trying to find a triangle and throw it over the top, but Vic threw a terrible bullet pass, so here we are trying to stop somebody on a pick 6. I try to strip him again and get it. We're going to have time tied up. All right, halftime tied up. I get ball first at the half. I'm going to establish this running game because I got out of my ways. And I hit the hole real strong. Coleman going down the side. Hey, establish the run, baby. As you can see, I take an easy 10-3 lead. I know I gotta stop him. He trying to get Christian McCaffrey involved. I'm trying to get the ball. Strip him, use a strip. Yes, sir. I need it. Jamal Adams. I'm trying to get up. I'm trying to go with it. Madden say no. Christian McCaffrey get up off the ground. Come later, boom.
Second and 12.
I know I gotta get some type of points out of this drive. He's trying to double bait. I throw a dot. He dropped the ball again. I throw him there. I'm just gonna take my field goal. Put me up by 2 possessions. Third quarter. That's all you need. I know when I get the ball back, I'm gonna try to shoot this clock. Second and seven. He been driving pretty good down the field. I see that he don't think I'm drunk. Give me though. That's a user alert. You thought I was going to let you have that? No. As you can see, now I'm trying to tour around with him, trying to see what Vic could do. Because it was one of my first times playing with Vic. I roll out. On the run accurate. He throwing the dot that comes. That's easy money. Celebrating end zone. As you can see, my opponent paused the game. You know the time it is. That's the end of it all. I'm the one on the kid, Wes. This is Not Fair Gaming, and I'm out.